I have a question. Who feels stressed out right now? So all of you know that stress can make you feel bad. It can make it hard for you to focus. It can make you jittery. It can give you headaches. It can make you tense, and it can make it hard for you to sleep. Stress can affect your bodies in lots of ways, and most of them aren't good. I have one more question for you. Who here knows how to deal with their stress? Hi, my name is Lawrence Chester, and today I'm going to be talking about how to deal with your stress and facing through your problems. In this day and age, we're faced with a lot of problems and difficulties, but we barely know how to handle them. As a sixth grader in the 21st century, I'm faced with a lot of problems and difficulties also, and so are my friends. I surveyed adults and friends, and here's what I found the main stress topics. Testing and not being prepared for them. Homework, not having the right technology for learning, forgetting stuff and being disorganized, keeping our grades up, after school activities, not enough time, not enough eating and staying active, our relationship with our friends, and trying to be ourselves but pleasing others. And you parents are faced with a lot of responsibilities also. Your responsibilities can affect how you live, thrive, your stress levels, and your overall well-being. Some of the things your parents are faced with are bills and money, taxes, making sure your kids are safe and sound, not enough time and too many things to do, your annoying bosses and annoying coworkers, your family, marriage, not enough sleep, and not taking care of yourselves. This can lead up to stress and difficult times. These unhappy feelings can affect friendships, relationships, and maybe even marriages. You can face problems in your workspace or community also. But Robert Kiyosaki once said, inside of each problem lies an opportunity. So find your opportunity to fight off your stress. And here's some ways you can start. First, address the problem and face it head on. Second, share the problem with someone you trust. A problem shared is a problem half solved. Third, learn to say no. Most of people's stress comes from trying to please others, then you take on their stress for yourself. Learning to say no can prevent stress. And finally, take some time for yourself to relax, because only you can truly take control of your stress. Some things you can also try are taking a day for yourself, like on a road trip or to the spa, doing something that is fun and relaxing for you, like a new hobby or a show you enjoy. Meditate, pray, release your strength, but don't let it consume you. You can even try things like taking a deep breath and holding it in. I remember when I was a kindergartner, Miss Singman taught all of us kindergartners that when you're mad, sad, angry, nervous, or just not being ourselves, that we can take a deep breath and let it out and help us calm down and de-stress. Even though you might not know it, your family and friends know when you're stressed and there's something going on with you. Stress can be contagious. It can affect more than just you. I've seen my own parents handle stress. My mom unplugs from the world and just doesn't be herself. Well, my dad has many things on his mind and can't focus on one thing. But if you take control of your own stress, you can make you, your family, and friends happy and healthier. Thank you.